Are you living in tropical country or areas with mild to fair temperatures? Maybe you have encountered this species that I'm going to share with you. Tetramorium bicarinatum is one of the most abundant species of Tetramorium and is spread throughout the globe. It has a common name of Guinea ant. They are medium-sized ant with a reddish head, mesosoma, and waist contrasting with a dark duster. I caught this queen some time ago. When I saw her, she's still wearing her wings and up to laying her first eggs. She laid another batch of eggs after some days, and then they eventually developed as her first batch of workers. And the queen finally shed her wings. One day, I offered protein food to them. And eventually, trophallaxis was observed in the colony. Looks like our queen was satisfied with the taste of the food. But OAP supporters observe closely the queen and workers' actions. They appear to be injecting something in the larvae. It seems they are feeding them a red bait. Days pass by, the colony successfully produced another workers and brood. I am so excited to transfer them in a form aquarium, or maybe connecting an outworld to their nest. After watching them for quite some time, I noticed that the tube has become grimy. Their litter is not usually located in one area, but is scattered on the test tube. So messy, right? I will transfer them to a new clean test tube, so they will have a fresh environment to grow the queen's colony. This species has a monomorphic worker crest, and their head shape is roughly sub-rectangular. But my queen produced different sizes of workers. Have you noticed a difference? Tetramorium bicarinatum queens are semi-claustral. Semi-claustral queens require foraging area and access to food during the founding stages. Last year, I left this colony for almost 3 weeks due to work assignments in far provinces, so the queen and workers didn't eat during the entire time. I thought that they are already dead when I got home, but surprisingly, the colony survived. Maybe eating affects the size of workers. Most ants are considered pests in urban areas, but this Tetramorium bicarinatum is not considered an economical pest species. They are capable of stinging, but it is not reported to be aggressive to be considered a serious stinging pest, unlike the fire ants. Observe with me on the forthcoming videos of their colony development. Thanks for watching, guys.